Dear students, welcome to the class. Today I will start the exercise 5.2, and in this we will learn how to divide one algebraic expression by the other algebraic expressions. So here is the first question. When I will solve the question, then in that duration I will explain you how to do it. So here the first question is, question number one is here, divide. A here, you have division minus 35 m cube by 5 mn. So here you can write, first you will write the quotient of the numerical coefficient. Okay, the quotient of the numerical coefficient. Okay, you will write here the quotient of the numerical. Numerical coefficient. Okay. So here the quotient of the numerical coefficient here. So what is coefficient here? That is this number minus 35. Minus 35 is the numerical coefficient here, and 5 is the numerical coefficient here. So when you divide minus 25 divided by 5, it will be minus 5. And next you will write the quotient of the variable. You will write the coefficient of the quotient of the variables. Quotient of the variables. Quotient of the variables means here, that is you have here mn cube divided by mn equal to how much. So here m and n, this will be cancelled out here, and n cube and n here, so it will be only n square, and therefore the quotient of the, that is the answer will be here. Therefore you can write that, therefore minus 25 m n cube divided by 5 m n equal to minus 5 n square. Okay, this is the answer of this question. So here you will write like this, the quotient of the numerical coefficient, the quotient of the numerical coefficient you will find, and then you will find the quotient of the variables. Okay, so this is the answer of this question. In this way you can solve. And also there is another method here, like alternatively here, just write here minus 25 m n cube divided by 5 m n, and this will be equal to minus 25 m n cube by 5 here m n. So see here that when you got this, when it will be here minus 1, and this m will cancel out here, and this n, here the power is 1 actually, so here it will be 2. So the answer is here minus, it is 5 here, minus 5, and minus 5 here, and then here n square. So minus 5 n square is the answer. So this is a simple way of doing this also. And in the book, this question is straight like this, but we can do this also like this, and you will get the answer quickly. And similarly, the question number C. Here I will do this, that is minus 210 m 4 m cube and m square divided by minus m 4 m square n. Okay, so here you will write like this, minus 210 m 4 m cube here, n square by minus 7 l 4 m square n. Okay, this is the question. So you say here that here the power of L is 4, here also L 4 here, so you can cancel. And here these two minus sign will cancel, and 7 3 here, 21, that is 30 here is 1, and here n square, then n cube, then there are 3 n's here and there are 2 n's here, so 2 n's will be here, will be you have n square and here will be n, so the answer is 30 m square n. Okay, so in this way you can find the answer. Now the question number 2, divide the following. So you have here 12 a cube plus 20 a square minus 28a. That's it. This is the expression, and we have to divide this by 4a. Okay, so here we will divide. Now see here that it is 4a here. So here we, you have to think. Yeah, but sochna padega ki 4a में क्या मल्टीप्लाई करने से 12 a क्यूब हो जाएगा. तो यू नो दैट 4 से अगर तो 3 जो करना पड़ेगा इसमें, दैट इज 4 into 3 इक्वल टू 12, बट वी हैव टू ब्रिंग a क्यूब हियर, सो इट इज ऑलरेडी a हियर. ओके, सो यू हैव टू मल्टीप्लाई 8 into a स्क्वायर, दैट इज a क्यूब हियर, सो यू हैव टू मल्टीप्लाई 3 a स्क्वायर. ओके, दैट इज इफ यू मल्टीप्लाई 3 a स्क्वायर into 4a, then you will get 4a into 3a square, so 4 3 a cube. So here this is our question, that is 3a square, so we will write 3a square over this, or here also you can write 3a square, and when you multiply this and this, you will get here 12 a cube, then I 12 a cube here. Okay, so this is the first step here, and then subtract this, so it will be 0. Okay, then this will come here, that is 20 a square. Now here again we have to think, what should we multiply in 4a to get 20 a square. So it is here, if you multiply 5 a here, okay, if you multiply 5 a, see here, 4 into 5 will be 20 a square. So it means that 5 will write here, and then here write 20 a square, and then subtract again, here is 0. So next, now here this will be coming down here, minus 28 a. Now think of a number which when multiplied by 4 a to get minus 28 a here. So because a is here and a is here already, so we have to multiply any number, so it is minus 7. Okay, when you multiply here minus 7, in this you will get minus 28 a here, so write here minus 7 here, and then minus 28 here, and then when you subtract here it will be plus sign and then 0, so the remainder is 0. So this is the, so here you will write the quotient equal to what, the quotient therefore here quotient equal to 3 a square plus 5 a minus 7, and remainder equal to here 0. Okay, so this is the answer of this question. Okay, so in this way you can divide, and here remember that here this is a trinomial and this is a monomial, so we have other questions in which you can have this trinomial or polynomial, and you can have the binomial or the trinomial here. Okay, so I will do, this is the question number A. Now the next question is, okay, now question number B, 2B. Here we have this polynomial divided by a binomial, 10A cube minus 11 a square plus 19 a plus 10 and divided by 5 a plus 2. Okay, here we have to divide this 5 a plus 2, 10 a cube. 10 a cube minus 11 a square plus 19 a plus 10. So now we have to divide here. Now again, we will do the same thing as I have done in the previous question. So it is here 10 a cube. Okay, this is 10. This is 10 a cube. Now here, what should you multiply to 5 a to get 10 a cube? So here 10 is here, so 5 3 are 10, so one number is 2, that is 5a into 2, and here again a and here a cube, so here a square, so then you have 10 a cube here. So here we have multiplied this expression to this here, so you have here, see that, now it is 2a square here, so 5a plus 2 into 2a square, okay then. It will be 5 via 10 a cube plus 4 a square. Okay, so we will write here. हमको करना क्या है यहाँ पर कि हमको देखना है कि यहाँ पर हमको मतलब इस जगह पे हमको जितना ये लिखा हुआ है उतना ही आ रहा है यहाँ पर. ओके, उसके लिए हमको यहाँ करना पड़ेगा 2 a square, तो इससे मतलब 5 से मल्टीप्लाई किया तो यहाँ पर आ गया. अब यहाँ पर कुछ भी आए उससे कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ता. ओके, इट डजंट मैटर व्हाट इज कमिंग हियर, बट बिलो दिस वी मस्ट हैव the same number. Okay, the same expression here. So here the our appropriate expression is here 2a square. So if we write 2a square, if you multiply 2a square with 5a plus 2, then you will get 10a cube. See, 10a cube, 10a cube is here. So they are same here and it is different here. So it doesn't matter here. So write here 10a cube plus 4a square. Okay, and write this 2a square here. 2 is 5. Now here you will subtract, okay? So here the sign minus will be here and this will be minus. When you subtract this, then the sign of this will change here. Now this plus sign is not useful, okay? This is not useful here now. Now here we have this minus sign. So minus 11, minus 4 will be, and these two will be cancelled here because plus minus 0. So minus 11 is square, minus 4 is going to be minus 15 a square, and then right here also plus 19 a. Okay, here two terms are enough because here we have only the binomial, so we will bring only the one term here. So that here now you have two terms. Now again think ki isme 5a mein kya multiply karna hai, so that the answer will be minus 15 a square. Theek hai, to yahan pe kya karna padega 5a mein, to you know 5 3 are 15, lekin yahan par negative hai, तो हमको लेना पड़ेगा माइनस 3. तो नंबर तो मिल गया माइनस 3. दूसरी बात यहाँ पर है ए स्क्वायर और यहाँ पर लिखा हुआ है ए, तो हमको इसमें क्या करना पड़ेगा, एक और इसे मल्टीप्लाई करना पड़ेगा. सो द एक्सप्रेशन इज माइनस 3a. तो माइनस 3 को लिखेंगे यहाँ पर माइनस 3a. ओके, और उसके बाद नाउ सी हियर, फाइव ए प्लस टू इंटू माइनस 3a, तो दिस इंटू दिस इक्वल टू माइनस 15 ए स्क्वायर एंड दिस इंटू दिस इक्वल टू माइनस 6a. नाउ यू विल राइट दिस एक्सप्रेशन हियर, माइनस 15 ए स्क्वायर माइनस 6a. देन अगेन द साइन विल चेंज, इट विल बी प्लस एंड दिस विल बी प्लस हियर आल्सो, एंड दिस टू विल कैंसिल बिकॉज माइनस 15 प्लस 0 एंड हियर 19 प्लस 6 विल बी 25 ए एंड देन ब्रिंग दिस 10 हियर. नाउ यू हैव 25 ए, सो नाउ मल्टीप्लाई हियर 5. ओके, देन राइट हियर 5, हियर 2 ए स्क्वायर माइनस 3 ए प्लस 5. ओके, सो नाउ इफ यू राइट 5, देन 5 हैव 25 ए प्लस 5 टू हियर 10, then minus and minus here, so here you will have 0 and 0, so that is eventually 0, just write 0 here. So this is the answer. So here you can write a quotient, quotient equal to 2a square minus 3a plus 5, and remainder equal to 0. one polynomial by the other polynomial, and here the divisor, you will have the divisor only a binomial or a trinomial. Okay, so this is the answer of this question. Now you will solve the other question yourself. Now the question number 3, find the quotients and remainders in each of the following. Here also we have to divide just like this question, but this will be little bit longer. Question number 3. So question number 3, you have the expression 6p4 minus 5pq plus 8p square minus 4p plus 7, and then you have here the divisor is p plus 1, and then you will divide this. Okay, so how will you divide? Again, I explained you that what is the process here. And यहाँ पर करना क्या पड़ेगा? हमको 6p4 लाना है. तो अब हमको सोचना पड़ेगा कि यहाँ पर इसमें क्या multiply करेंगे. So here 6pq. If you multiply 6pq, then you will get this. So 6pq. So 6pq into p will be 6p to the power 4 and plus 6pq. Then sub minus here, minus, so these two will be here cancelled out because plus minus will be 0, and minus 5pq and minus 6pq here. Now see that here we have to add or separate the like terms only here. So it is pq, it is pq, so these are the like terms. It is minus 5pq, this is minus 6q here. So it will be minus 11pq. And next, write here 8p square. Then now here we have to bring 11pq here, then write here minus 11p square. So you will have here minus 11pq minus 11p square. Then here plus, and plus also here. Then plus 8 plus 11 will be 19p square, and minus 4p. Now write here that 19p here, okay, 19p, then 19p into p, 19p square plus 19p here, then minus, so this will cancel, minus 4 minus 19 will be 23p, and this plus 7 will come here, then you have minus 20, here write minus 23p now. Minus 23 only, because p is already there, yes. So minus 23, p minus 23. So plus and plus, then 7 plus 23 will be here 30. So here the quotient is, quotient equal to 6pq minus 11p square plus 19p minus 23, and remainder equal to 30. This is the answer of this question. Okay, now here in the question number 4, we have to divide again in this way. That is the process same here. That is for division, we will divide just like this. Okay, but here we have also one more question, that is we have to verify the result. That is when we divide, then we will also check whether our answer is correct or not. So what is the process of checking the answer? You know the division algorithm, that divisor into quotient plus remainder equal to dividend. So you will use that and then find out whether you will check. Like in this, you can also check this division, like multiplying. This is the divisor here and this is the quotient. So this this expression into this expression plus 30 will come to this. Okay, that means that it is correct. So here we will do that in this question number 4. Okay, question number 4. Here A 3 first divide with 3x cube. Minus 5x square minus 11x minus 3 and divided by x minus 3. Okay, so this is the question, and first we will divide here x minus 3, then it is 3x cube, so here it will be 3x square, so 3x cube minus 9 x square. And here how did I get this? Okay, I explained you before. So here it is minus and then plus, then this will cancel here. Minus 5 plus 9 will be 4 x square minus 11 x, then here 4 x square here, so multiply this with 4 x, so it is plus 4 x, then 4 x square minus 12 x, then minus, then plus, so minus 11 plus 12 will be x only, and x minus 3 here, then here write here plus 1, then you have x minus 3, then minus and then plus, so the remainder is 0. Okay, so here quotient equal to 3x square plus 4x plus 1 and remainder equal to 0. Now verification. Then divisor. Divisor into quotient plus remainder. And here division divisor will be x minus 3 is the divisor. And quotient is 3 square plus 4x plus 1 plus greater than 0. Then multiply these two, x into 3 square, 3x cube, x into 4x will be 4x square. X into 1 will be x, then plus minus 3 into this, minus 3, minus 9 x square, minus 12 x minus 3. Okay, here x into 3x square is 3x cube, x into 4x is 4x square, x into 1 is x, minus 3 into 3x square is minus 9x square, minus 3 into 4x is minus 12x, and minus 3 into minus plus 1 equal to minus 3, and then 3x cube plus 4x square minus plus x minus 12x minus 3. I have rearranged the like terms, so 3x cube minus 5x square minus 11x minus 3. Now check whether this is the same as this. Now see, it is the 3x cube, 3x cube minus 5x square, minus 5x square, minus 11x, minus 11x, and minus 3, minus 3. That is, this is equal to division. Okay. Verified. So this is how you will check your division. Okay. So this is the question. Then now I will move on to this next exercise. That is, this was the exercise, you know, 5.2. Okay, so next is the 5.3. Okay, now I will start the exercise 5.3. In this we have to learn some identities. Okay, identities are the formulas here. Okay, so we have to use some formulas, and there are the basic formulas like you have the question formula number 1, x plus y whole square, and number 2, x plus y whole square, and number 3, x square minus y square. Okay, and we have these three formulas, and when you expand, then it will be x square plus 2x, 2xy plus y square, and here x square minus 2xy plus y square, and this will be x minus y into x plus y. Okay, these are the three formulas, and these are the identities, and we have to, you must learn these three identities properly, and it will be used in this exercise. Okay, x plus y, x minus y, and x plus y into x minus y. Okay, actually here it should be here, this should be here, and this should be here, but it's okay. X plus y into x plus y will be equal to x square plus y square. Okay, so here actually how do we get here x plus y? If you multiply x plus y whole square, it will be x plus y into x plus y. Okay, so when you multiply, that will be x plus y plus y, x plus y, and then it will be x square plus xy plus here xy plus y square. Y into x equal to xy, then x square plus 2xy plus y square. Okay, so here see that when you multiply, then this it is x square plus xy plus xy plus y square. So xy plus xy will be 2xy here, and then the formula is x square plus 2xy plus y square. Similarly, we can find out the other formulas here. If you multiply this and this, you will get this. If you open this again, you will get this. Okay, so these are the three formulas, and all the questions are based on this formula. So let us solve the question number 1A. Question number 1A. Here, use the suitable identities to expand. Okay, we have to expand this. So the first question is A plus 7B whole square. So again, use this formula here. Actually, this is the formula. Okay, so here I will explain you how to use this formula. So actually, what is this here? The x and y are the placeholders. Okay, you can think of like you can write x in place of x as a box. Okay, that is keep some things, है ना, मतलब एक बॉक्स है, इसमें हम कुछ रख सकते हैं, जो भी रखना है रख लो, इसमें x रख दो, y रख दो, 2 रख दो, 3 रख दो, minus 5, 4 कुछ भी रख दो, ठीक है? और यहाँ पर ये अभी मतलब ब्लैंक बॉक्स है, और इसके बाद क्या है दूसरा, एक सपोज एक सर्किल है, ये दूसरे तरह का बॉक्स है, इसमें भी हम लोग कुछ रख सकते हैं, कोई भी नंबर, ठीक है? उसके बाद क्या है मतलब इन दोनों का होल स्क्वायर, तो क्या होगा यहाँ पर कि जब इसको हम ओपन करेंगे, मतलब ये एक्स या वाई है, ऐसे समझ लो, और उसके बाद क्या हो जाएगा, ये एक्स स्क्वायर x y plus y square, मतलब ये यहाँ पर क्या हो जाएगा, ये box into box हो जाएगा, plus 2 into box into circle plus circle into circle, मतलब जैसे अगर मान लो यहाँ पर हमने 2 लिया हुआ है और यहाँ पर 3 लिया हुआ है, तो यहाँ पर क्या हो जाएगा 2 और यहाँ हो जाएगा 2 और यहाँ हो जाएगा 3 और यहाँ हो जाएगा 3 और यहाँ हो जाएगा 3, तो क्या हो जाएगा 2 4 plus 2 4 12 plus 9, इसको plus कर देंगे, ठीक है? ये तो इसकी बात हो गई, बट अगर मान लो इसके जगह पे कुछ और लिखा हुआ है, सपोज हमने यहाँ पर, ठीक है, ओके, यहाँ पर सपोज 2 लिखा हुआ है यहाँ पर, और यहाँ पर लिख दिया हमने सपोज 3, x लिख दिया हमने सपोज, ठीक है, अब क्या हो जाएगा, यहाँ पर 2 है और यहाँ पर 3x है, तो यहाँ पर तो 2 होगा क्योंकि ये बॉक्स है, तो बॉक्स में 2 है, तो यहाँ बॉक्स में 2 ही होगा, और यहाँ पर भी 2 होगा, लेकिन यहाँ पर क्या हो जाएगा, इसमें x हो जाएगा और यहाँ पर भी x होगा और यहाँ पर भी x हो जाएगा, तो फिर यहाँ पर क्या हो जाएगा, ये 2 3 4 3 अगर यहाँ पर हो जाएगा x, और यहाँ पर क्या हो जाएगा 9x² हो जाएगा, तो कहने का मतलब ये हुआ ऐसे समझना पड़ेगा एंड देन इट विल बी वेरी इजी ओके। जैसे यहां पर लिखा हुआ है ए लिखा हुआ है और 7 भी लिखा हुआ है यानी कि यहां पर मतलब क्या हो जाएगा ए हो जाएगा इसमें और यहां हो जाएगा इसमें 7 बी लिखेंगे यहां पर क्योंकि यहां पर बॉक्स में क्या हो जाएगा जहां भी बॉक्स होगा वहां पर ए लिखेंगे और जहां पर बी सर्किल होगा वहां लिखेंगे 7 बी और फिर उसको हम सिंपलीफाई कर देंगे हो जाएगा। जैसे कि यहां पर ये लिखा तो यहां पर जाएगा ए यहां पर जाएगा ए और यहां पर ए और 7 बी और यहां पर जाएगा 7 बी और 7 बी तो क्या हो जाएगा इसलिए ए स्क्वायर प्लस 7 टू जा 40 ए भी हो जाएगा और यहां पर जाएगा 49 बी स्क्वायर। गॉट द आंसर ठीक है। सो दिस इज द वे इन व्हिच यू विल रिमेंबर द फार्मूला एंड this concept can be used in any of these formulas okay। you can think of just as the x or y jo hai wo alag alag tarah ke matlab ek jagah hai rakhne ka theek hai lekin dono separate hai okay। to yahan par wahi karna padega if you understand and if you understand this then there is no need to write these boxes but here I have used these square and circle to explain you this okay। so here the answer will be here again use the formula here a square x square plus 2 square plus y square here that is here will be you have a square plus 2 into a into 7b plus 7b whole square okay। so this will be a square plus 14ab plus 49 and b square so this is the answer okay। so this is the answer of this question। similarly you can do the other questions we'll solve one more question that is 4x question number c okay। question number c is here 4x minus 7 by 2 y whole square okay। see here now in the place of that is the square you have 4x here okay। so you have in the square it will be 4x okay because and minus is there then here minus 2 into square that is 4x and then your circle here that is 7 by 2 y and plus 7 by 2 y and 7 by 2 y so then you have the answer here 16 x square and here 4 2 jar 8 8 7 jar 56 so it will be minus 56 by 2x y and here will be 49 by 4 and y square okay। and here when you plot this it will be actually here 28 okay। you can write 28 directly here and here this 2 will cut okay। so here the answer is 16x square minus 28xy plus 49 by 4 y square okay। so this is the answer of this question। so here whatever is there in this you will replace that here and then simplify okay। so this is the answer। now here the next question here again we will use the here I have used the formula x minus y whole square because here it is minus so you will use x minus y whole square and when it is plus then use this formula। now here in the second question we have to use this formula okay। So 6m is here and it is here l by n. And here also 6m and here l by n. So we will write here that 6m l by n and l by n here. So you will have 36 m square minus n square by n square is the answer. Okay. So here this is the formula, that is x plus y equal to don't write this, okay, here I will just explain you. And here the answer is 6m square minus l by n whole square. Okay. And that should be 36 m square minus l square by n square is the answer. Okay. But if you have difficulty, then you can understand like this. I hope you would get this point. Okay. So the other question is similar. Okay, so you will solve that question. Now question number 3, find the square of each of the following. Okay, we have to find this square. question number 5. Here you are given x plus y equal to 11 and xy equal to 2. X plus y equal to 11. And then we have find the value of x square plus y square. We have to find the value of x square plus y square equal to tau. So here first x plus y equal to 11. We get squaring both sides, we get here x plus y whole square equal to 11 square, so it will be x square plus y square plus 2xy equal to 121. So x square plus y square plus, what is xy here? 2. So 2 into 2 equal to 121. Okay. So x square plus y square plus 4 equal to 121 117. So this is the answer of this question. Okay, xy equal to 2, then root is of 4, then this will go here, and when you subtract, you will get the answer 117. So this is the answer of this question. Then question number 6 is similar, okay? So you will do it yourself. And then question number 7. Question number 7 is x minus 1 by x equal to 50, it is given. And then find value of x square plus 1 by x square. Then find the value of x square plus 1 by x square this. Then again here you will square this, okay, this 15 here. So squaring both sides, this x square plus 2xy plus y square, so x square minus this x will cut here, minus 2 plus 1 by so this is the answer of this question. Okay, so you are given this, then you will square both sides and then simplify, and then you will get the answer. So now there are some more questions on this side, and the question number 8 is there also. I will do question number 9. Okay, question number 9. In the question number 9, you are given x minus 1 by x equal to root 3, then find the value of x square plus 1 by x square and x4 plus 1 by x4. The first part of this question number 9 is similar to the question number 7, okay? The second part is also similar. So I will solve question number 8, okay? I will not solve this because question number 9 is similar to question number 7, okay? So question number 8, here x square plus 1 by x square, 79, then we have to find value of x plus 1 by x, okay, we have to find the value of this, So in this question, between this x square plus 1 by x square, so first write here that x plus 1 by x whole square equal to how much it will be x square plus y square, x plus x square plus 2 into x into 1 by x plus 1 by x whole square. Okay, this is the formula. Next, this will cut x square plus 2 plus 1 by x square, then you have x square plus 1 by x square plus 2. Now we are given the value of this x square plus 1 by x square is 79. So right here 79 plus 2 equal to 81. So that is, here you have x plus 1 by x whole square equal to 81. Then we have to find the value of x plus 1 by x. So it will be equal to root 81, that is x plus 1 by x equal to 9 is the answer of this question here. Okay, so here in this, so you will do this question like this. Okay, we have find value of x plus 1 by x. So first start with this identity, x plus 1 by x equal to x square plus 2 into x into 1 by x plus, that is you will use the formula x plus y whole square, and then open this, and then here this value is given here. Then put this value from the given, then it is 81, then this equal to 81, then this is the square here, so it will go here, then it will be root, then x plus 1 by x equal to answer. Okay, so this is the, and then you will do other questions. Okay, there are many questions, and you will solve them yourself. Now I will move on to the exercise 5.4. Okay, exercise 5.4. In this also we have to factorize. Okay, here we have to factorize. You know factorization. What is the meaning of factorization? Like we factorize the numbers, you know, factorization of number. Like if you have 27, then you write 3 into 3 into 3. This is the factorization. That is, we have to break a given number into the factors. Like here 3 into 3 into 3. And here, now this cannot be further. यही कर सकते हैं कि आप इनको इसको और आगे हम इसको ब्रेक नहीं कर सकते. ओके, वी कैन नॉट फर्दर ब्रेक इट डाउन टू द स्मॉलेस्ट नंबर्स, बट दिस इज द आंसर ऑफ दिस. एंड सिमिलरली वी हैव द फैक्टराइजेशन ऑफ द एक्सप्रेशंस, अलजेब्रिक एक्सप्रेशंस. फॉर एग्जांपल देयर इज एक्सप्रेशन हियर 30 एक्स स्क्वायर वाई. ओके, नाउ हियर वी कैन आल्सो फैक्टराइज दिस. First you have the number, numerical value, that is 30. So 10 3 are 30, or 2 into 5 into 3. Okay, that is the factors of 30. Then you have x into y. Okay, these are the factors of this expression. Okay, so these are the factors. So this is the factorization. So there are some methods of factorization. Like you have the case one here, factorization by taking out a common factor. Okay, factorization by taking out a common factor. Basically, example the terms mein. For example here 5pq. 5pq minus 15 p square plus 35p. यहाँ पर ये मतलब क्या, दिस इज द अलजेब्रिक एक्सप्रेशन, और इसको हमको फैक्टराइज करना है. तो इसमें क्या करना पड़ेगा, हियर वी हैव टू टेक द कॉमन. मतलब कॉमन का मतलब क्या हुआ कि ऐसा मतलब कोई नंबर या फिर कोई लिटरल, मतलब ए बी सी डी एक्स वाई जेड कुछ भी है, तो वो मतलब सब में होना चाहिए. जैसे यहाँ पर लिखा हुआ है 5pq लिखा हुआ है, तो यहाँ पर इसका मतलब क्या है, 5 इंटू पी इंटू इंटू पी इंटू पी लिखा हुआ है. ठीक है, इसका मतलब ये है. और यहाँ पे क्या लिखा हुआ है 15 टी स्क्वायर लिखा हुआ है, तो क्या लिखते हैं उसमें 3 इंटू 5 इंटू टी इंटू टी लिखा हुआ है, और यहाँ पे लिखा हुआ है 35 टी, सो इट इज 7 5 35 5 इंटू 7 इंटू टी। अब ऐसा इसमें क्या है, मतलब ऐसा कौन सा इसमें नंबर या फिर कोई लेटर जो कि सब में है, तो यहाँ पर देखो इसमें यहाँ पर ये 5 है, यहाँ पर 5 है, यहाँ पर 5 है, और यहाँ पर 5 है, मतलब ये 5 जो है वो सब में है, और फिर इसके बाद एक पी सब में है, एक पी बस, लेकिन ये वाला पी यहाँ पर है, पी यहाँ पर है, पी यहाँ पर है, लेकिन मतलब इसमें थर्ड सेकंड पीस में नहीं है, और यहाँ पर पी है इसमें, यहाँ पर भी नहीं, यहाँ पर भी नहीं है, दैट इज ओनली वन पी इज कॉमन इन ऑल दिस थ्री, तो इसका मतलब क्या हुआ 5 पी यहाँ पर क्या होगा कॉमन होगा इसमें 5 पी, तो इसका मतलब ये होगा कि 5 पी यहाँ से निकाल देंगे तो क्या बन जाएगा यहाँ पर, जैसे 5 पी यहाँ पर है, तो इफ यू रिमूव दिस 5 पी तो यहाँ पर बन जाएगा पी स्क्वायर बन जाएगा, इसमें पी स्क्वायर हो गया, यहाँ से 5 पी निकाल देंगे क्या बन जाएगा इसमें 3 पी बन जाएगा पर, और यहाँ से 5 पी निकाल देंगे बन जाएगा पर 7, तो इसका मतलब इफ यू राइट दिस देन टू बी 5 पी देन विद इन द ब्रैकेट टू बी हियर पी स्क्वायर माइनस 3 पी क्योंकि यहाँ माइनस है इसमें और प्लस यहाँ हो जाएगा 7, सो दिस इज द फैक्टराइजेशन, यहाँ पर ये 5 पी जो था वो सब में था उसको बाहर निकाल दिया और जो बच गया उसको लिख दिया ब्रैकेट में, सो दिस इज कॉल्ड फैक्टराइजेशन ओके बाय टेकिंग द कॉमन टर्म्स। Okay, in the same way, now we can also use the identities like the x plus y whole square, x plus y whole square or x plus y into x minus y. By using the identities, we can also vectorize. And there is here one more important method of factorization, that is by splitting the middle term. Okay. This is the most important part here, factorization by splitting. Splitting the middle term. Factorization by splitting the middle term. So in this and here you have the expression like this, that is x square plus bx plus 6. See here. मतलब कहने का क्या हुआ इसमें कि हम लोग मतलब इस तरह के जो expressions होंगे उन सबको इस method से हम factorize कर सकते हैं. That is we can factorize by splitting the middle term of only those expressions which are like this, that is here x square plus bx plus c, यहाँ पर x square, x यहाँ पर क्या है variable है and a b c are the constants, so we can factorize this kind of expression by using the method of the splitting the middle term, okay, so what is the method here, यहाँ पर जो method है उसका method क्या यहाँ पर है, when I will solve some questions that will be clear, okay, take example here p square plus 11 p plus 18, ठीक है, ये मतलब क्या है, ये जो एक्सप्रेशन है दिस इज जस्ट लाइक दिस, ओके, नाउ यू सी दैट यहाँ पर a लिखा हुआ है और यहाँ पर कुछ नहीं है, मतलब x स्क्वायर के बदले p स्क्वायर लिखा हुआ है और यहाँ पर x के बदले p लिखा हुआ है एंड c के बदले यहाँ पर 8 लिखा हुआ है, सो इसको करना कैसे, सो इट इज हियर p स्क्वायर, लेकिन यहाँ पर क्या है, यहाँ पर 1 तो है ही यहाँ पर, ठीक है, 1 है यहाँ पर 1, that is in place of a we have 1 here, in place of b we have 11 and in place of c we have 18 here, तो अब यहाँ पर क्या है, पहले यहाँ पर हमको यहाँ जो ये p square है और ये constant है इन दोनों को multiply करना है, तो यहाँ पर क्या होगा ये 1 into 18 तो कितना हो गया 18 हो गया यहाँ पर, ठीक है 18 हो गया यहाँ पर, अब क्या करना है इसमें कि 18 है तो now you can write 18 in many ways like 1 into 18 and you can also write here 2 into 9 equal to 18 here and also 3 into 6 equal to 18, ठीक है, these are the ways, है ना, मतलब हमको that is we can write 18 in these ways, ठीक है, और कोई तरीका नहीं लिखने का, so we can write only in 3 ways here, अब यहाँ पर ये हो गया, उसके बाद क्या है कि अब यहाँ पर ये बड़े तरफ यहाँ पर क्या है, ये 11 पे यहाँ पर है, ये हमको इतना 11, यहाँ पर नंबर 11 आया है यहाँ पर, अब देखना है कि मतलब जैसे यहाँ पर है 1 और 80, 80 का यहाँ पर क्या है, 2 फैक्टर है। हियर यू हैव 2 फैक्टर्स ऑफ 80, 1 एंड 18, ठीक है। तो 18 प्लस 1 या 18 माइनस 1 क्या होगा, 11 तो नहीं होगा। लाइक 18 प्लस 1 90 हो जाएगा, या फिर 18 माइनस 1 हो जाएगा यहाँ पर 17, लेकिन हमको चाहिए यहाँ पर 11, तो ये नहीं आ रहा है, तो इसको मतलब छोड़ देंगे। देन यू हैव 2 इंटू 9 इज देयर, नाउ सी 2 प्लस 9 इक्वल टू 11, ठीक है, एंड 2 माइनस 9 इक्वल टू 7। तो यहाँ पर प्लस करने से तो आ रहा है यहाँ पर 11, सो हियर दिस इज द राइट चॉइस फॉर स्प्लिटिंग दिस, ओके। सो हियर यू विल राइट पी स्क्वायर प्लस, नाउ यू राइट 11p एज 2p प्लस 7p, 2p प्लस हियर 9p एंड देन प्लस 18, ओके। सो नाउ सी हियर दैट हियर यू हैव 2p, दैट इज 11p इज इक्वल टू 2p प्लस 9p। नाउ 2p इनटू 9p विल बी इक्वल टू हियर 18p स्क्वायर हियर, एंड सी दैट 18 इनटू p स्क्वायर इज आल्सो इक्वल टू p स्क्वायर इनटू 18 इज आल्सो इक्वल टू 18p स्क्वायर, ओके। सो दीस टू कंडीशंस मस्ट बी फुलफिल्ड, देन यू कैन फैक्टराइज। नाउ दिस हियर, दिस इज हियर p स्क्वायर प्लस 2p प्लस 9p प्लस 18। नाउ हियर यू कैन टेक कॉमन बिटवीन दिस टू, सो p इज कॉमन हियर, सो p एंड p इज प्लस 2 हियर, एंड हियर आल्सो 9 एंड p प्लस 2, ओके। देन वी हैव हियर, नाउ आई कैन सी दैट हियर एंड हियर वी हैव कॉमन p प्लस 2 एंड p प्लस 2 कॉमन हियर, सो यू हैव p प्लस 2 कॉमन हियर, एंड देन इफ यू रिमूव दिस एंड दिस देन p प्लस 9 विल बी इन द ब्रैकेट। सो दिस इज द फैक्टराइजेशन ऑफ दिस एक्सप्रेशन बाय यूजिंग द method of the splitting the middle term, okay. So remember this process, sir, and then you can factorize. So now I will solve the questions from the exercise. Question number 1A, write down all the possible factors of the following. 8x to the power 5 y square, and here we have to write the we have to write all the factors of this, okay. So what are the all the factors of this? Here you will have 2 into 2 into 2 into x into x into x into x into into y, okay. So these are all the factors of this expression here. You have 5 times x here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 2 times here y, y into y, and 3 times 2 here. So these are the factors of this expression, okay. Similarly, you can write the factors of like minus, question number B, minus 13p square m square q cube. So it will be minus 13 into p into p into. So this is the answer of this question. Similarly, you can write the answer of other questions. Now, the question number 2, find the common factors of the following monomials. If we have to find the common factors of the monomials, 3p cube, and other is here, you have 21p square cube, okay. So 1 is 3p cube here, you can write here 3 into p into q, and here also you can write here 3 into 7 into p into p into q. So now what is common here? So common factor equal to 3p and Q. Now you can see here that 3 common and 1 P is common and Q is also common. So you have here 3 PQ is common from these two here. Okay. So similarly, now question number B also. You have here 18 x cube y square z 4 and other is 24 x y square z square. Now you can write here the factors of 18 as 2 into 3 into 3 into x into x into x into z, and also here 2 to the power 4 z here. Okay, that is we don't have to write every time like this. Okay, just, here I am writing just to explain you better. Okay, so here now see the common here. Now this 2 is common. Okay, but here only this 2 is common. Okay, now next is this 3 and this 3 is common here. Okay, only 1 3 is common. So this and this is common. Then next is this y and this y is common, and this y also common, and 1 z and 1 z is common. So what is common then? Here you will write the common factors equal to 2 into 3 into y into z, that is 6 y square z square. Okay, so we can find here also, like actually this 6 is the HCF of 18 and 24, and here you can also directly write, like here is x cube and here x. So here only 1 x is common here, and y square, so y square is common here, and here z 4 and z square. That is in the literals, that is when you have the variables, then you will see the lowest power. Like here x cube and x, then x will be common, and here both are equal, so y square is common here. Here z 4 z square means z square must be common here. Okay, so the answer is this. Similarly, you can do the other questions. Now the question number 3, find the common factors of the following expressions. Question number 3. Five x to the power 4 plus 25 m square m cube minus 25 m square n square m cube n square. Okay, this is the expression. 5 m to the power 4, 25 m square n cube, and 25 m cube n square. So here what is the factor which is common here? Now see, observe here the number first. Okay, see the number first here. You have 5 and 25 and here 25. So the HCF of 5, 25, 25 will be 5. So 5 is common here. Then see the power of m here. It is 4 here, it is square, and here cube here. So in this power, that is the power of m. Okay, so here the power is 4 and here it is 2 and here it is 3. So which is this power here? Sabse kam kaun sa hai? M square hai. Iska matlab ye m square yahan par common hoga. Then next here the power of n is here 3 and here n square, and here what is the power of n here? It is 0. Actually it is here the power of n is 0. So the least power of n is 0 here. So we will not, so it means that n is not common here. Okay, n is not common, so we will not write n here. So that is 5 m square is a common here. Then after taking this common, what is left? Left. So here it is 5 m square. So here m square is left, and plus 5 n cube and minus 5 here, because we have taken n square, so here m will be left and n square is there. So this is the answer of this question. When you multiply this with this, then again you will get the same expression. Okay, so this is how you will factorize . Now one more question I will do here, question number 3b. 11a² b² minus 77. b² c² a³. Okay, this is the expression and we have to take the common. So here, now see the number here 11 and 77. So in the number 11 and 77, 11 is common. Okay, so write 11. And then here it is a² and here it is a³. So a² is common, least power, and b² so least power is 1. So b is common here, c² equal, then write c². So you have here 11, we have taken a² b and c². So here only 1 is left here, 1, and it will be here 7, and a² we have taken, and c² also we have taken here, and b. So what is left here is a and b. So this is the answer. Okay, now see here that when you multiply this with this, you will get this here. 11, 7, 77, and a² into a equal to a³, and b into b equal to b², and c² is already there. Okay, so this is the answer of this question. Now the question number 4. Over here you have 2a, 4x minus 1 plus 5, 4x minus 1. Okay. Now here, this binomial and this binomial is common in both terms. So you will take this as 4x minus 1 as common. Then 2a plus 5 will be in the bracket. So this is the answer of this question. And then question number B. Here P, y minus b minus 2. Minus b. So again here y minus b common, then write minus b, and then p minus 2 is left here. So this is the answer. Now the question number 5. Here we have to make the groups here. Now see here that in these two terms, what is common here? PQ is common. So take PQ here common, then R minus 1 will be here, and from this minus 1 is common. So here also R minus 1. Okay. Now here you have to understand, like here it is PQ. So if you take common PQ here, then 1 will be left here. Okay. And here when you remove PQ, then R will be left here. So this, and here we see here in the term minus R and 1, only what is common here, only 1 is common, or you can say minus 1. So if you take minus 1 out here, then this will be positive and this will be negative. So here R minus 1. Now see here, here you have R minus 1 and here also you have R minus 1. So again you will take R minus 1 common, that is if you take common here, see, and here also this, then what is left here? PQ minus 1, so this will be within the bracket. Okay, this is the one here, and again I will write, I have just erased to explain you that when you remove this, what is there here? R minus 1, okay, that is here R minus 1, and this is here minus 1, and here also R minus 1. So if you remove this, then PQ is left here, and if you remove this, then minus 1 is here. So this is the answer of this question. R minus 1, PQ minus 1. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, क्वेश्चन नंबर बी, 2a² + 5ab ab + 6ab + 15b². So this is the question, 2a² + 5ab. Now here, in these two terms, what is found here? You can write only a is found here. So you have 2a + 5b. Okay, and if you take common here from this and this a, then here will be, you have 2a and here will be 5b. Now from these two again you can take common. It is here first c, 6 and 15. So what is common between 6 and 15? It is 3. Okay, and also here b and b are common here. So you will take common here 3b. So it will be here 2a + 5b. Now again we have 2a + 5b common. Then what is left? a + 3b. So this is the answer of this question. And now the next question. Characterize the following by using the suitable identities. Okay, question number 6 here. We have to use the identities. So this 4p² - 9q². Now here you can write this as 2p² - 3q² Then here you will use like x² - y². I told you that here, you know, x² - y² = x - y, x + y. Okay, this is the identity and use this here. So it will be here 2p - 3q and 2p + 3p. So this is the factorization of this expression by using the identity, this identity. Question number B, 16m⁴ - 144m³. So here first take common 16 and also m cube here. Okay, so here you have m² - 9. Okay, 16 m cube is, now it will be 16 m cube here, then m² - 3² = 16. By using the this identity, okay, x² + y² = x + y, x + y. So this is the answer of this question. Now the question number 7, factorize the following by using the suitable identities. So here again we have to use the identity. So the first question is x² - 6x + 9. Question number 7, a x² - 6x + 9. Okay, so here you will write x² - 2 × x × 3 + 3². Okay, now see, this is on the formula x² - 2xy + y². So you can write this as x - 3² = x - 3 or x - 3. Okay, so this is the factorization of this question by using the identity. I told you the identity here, x - y². Okay, here the simple method is, that is how will you find a and b. Okay, that is x and y. How will you find x and y here? So see the square term here. This is x² here and this is also 3² Okay. So first write in this place here x1² and in this place you write v square here. And then now you know what is x and what is y here. And then write here 2xy. Okay. And then write the answer. Question number B or do C. Okay. It is m4 plus 2 m square plus here m4. Okay. Now see here, write here m square whole square. Okay, here and here in this you write here n square whole square. So now you have got here the value of x and y. Okay, that is x and y you got here. Now write in the middle here. So because this plus here, so write it is 2. It is already there here m square and here n square. Okay, so then it will be m square plus n square whole square is the answer of this question. Okay. So now question number 8. Okay, that is by using the by splitting the middle term now. Okay.
If you are splitting fulfills these two conditions, then it is correct.
Okay, so and if it is not right, then you cannot factorize. So you must remember this. So now here you will take the common p here, p minus 8 plus 4 and p minus 8. So p minus 8 and p plus 4 is the answer. So in this way you can factorize the other questions also. Okay, so this is the end of this exercise and as well as this chapter also. So I have explained many terms and formula also, and also explained you how to solve the questions. So and your homework, okay, that is now it is your part to solve the questions, and I have not solved many questions. So those questions are for you to solve, okay, properly in your copy. Okay, so in the next class I will meet you, and then I will explain you the linear equations in one variables, okay, chapter 6. Okay, so thank you for watching.